Yeah, just makes me, again, not only connected to you, but connected much more to the book as well. So, Song in the Daylight. What is A Song in the Daylight about? First, I'm going to give you the movie pitch, one sentence, high concept answer. A Song in the Daylight is about a woman named Larissa Starr, who in the middle of her happily ever after married life, suddenly and inexplicably begins a life-changing affair with a much younger man. So whenever I tell my friends or acquaintances or people this, their reaction usually is some version of the following. Oh. What he thought about the subject matter of this book, I'm supposed to say that he replied, it's not the subject matter that concerned him, it was the research. So you can tell what our marriage has been like for the last 2 years. The idea for the story, this image that I have of the romantic woman looking out of her well-appointed windows of her well-appointed house has been floating around my heart and my head for some time, probably since 1995, somewhere between Red Leaves and 11 Hours, somewhere between baby number two and baby, what felt like 33, because it's just baby number three. And the thing that fascinated me about it, my initial fascination with it, was of this myth that we have of a romantic hero. And what is a romantic hero? A romantic hero in our classical romantic literature, in the literature of Herman Melville, or Nathaniel Hawthorne, or the Brothers Grimm, or Edgar Allan Poe, or William Wordsworth, or even our own Alexander Pushkin, has always been a man who was very much worthy of admiration. He was always a man who was a traveler, an adventurer. Many times he was a man on a horse, perhaps a horseman. He rebelled against society's rules. He did not want to live by conventional means. He wanted he was against tradition, and he tried to refashion a new world order based on his own ideals instead of the ideals of society. He placed very, very strong faith in the value of individualism because he himself was so independent, and we respected him for it. And he emphasized, or tried to emphasize, a less restrictive relationship between God and man and God and the human. Because he wanted to live by his own rules. He was passionate, he was emotional. He was a man who revered nature and found truth and beauty in nature. His heart turned to remote and faraway places when he dreamed, places like Australia. And as a romantic hero, he yearned for the infinite and he searched for the impossible. He was an outlaw. Well, we live in the modern age, and in the modern age we all say that women can be what men can be. So my interest and my idea and my question was, well, what if this romantic hero were a she and not a he? What if the romantic hero was a romantic heroine? Romantic heroine Larissa Starr. And so I